Network. TFNN. Headline news update.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Tommy O'Brien, coming to you live from TFNN, 9 a.m. Eastern Time, Thursday morning. 30 minutes to go until that opening bell, and we got markets right around positive territory. S&P is positive by a half a point at 33.16. We got the NASDAQ up 12 points at 11,103. The Dow up 30 points, 27,085. Another big day for gold, up $20 at 2,068. Silver up $1.32 at 28.19. Notes and bonds, higher price and lower yield, folks. The 10-year up 4 ticks at 140.06. The 30-year up 10 ticks at 182.13. And the story of the morning so far, weekly jobless claims coming in. Jumping over to that number, we have 1.186 million. The expectation was for 1.42 million. So under what the market was looking for. Continuing claims dropping by 844,000. To 16.1 million. This is the 20th straight week that we are dealing with a million plus claims, but the lowest total that we've had since the pandemic began in early April to late March. Harsh numbers, but the market liking what it's seeing so far as the indices trade a bit higher. All right, what else we got going on in the market? Quicken Loans, they're going public. I talked about it on my program. Be wary of this company, folks. Not often you have a company that is selling out to the public at a time when they have rapid growth coming in the future. If anything, they sell out to the public at their peak, the peak of their max growth, which could be right now, as you're seeing a 10-year yield sitting at about 0.53%. They tried to price it at about $20 to $22 for 150 million shares. They settled for 100 million shares at $18, raising $1.8 billion, valuing the company at $36 billion, and they start trading today. What else we got going on? How about those airline companies trading higher? Yesterday and last night, President Trump saying he's in favor of a plan to give $25 billion more to struggling airline industry. Whoops, jumping around to some of those stocks, folks. We had American. Look at these pops. Yesterday and then on the news last night on Trump himself, you trade from 1175 to 1375. We're back at about 1296 for American. Delta, you spike to 2756. Even the domestic Southwest to 33.72. JetBlue shares, we'll see how they react today, 10.85. We got Roku earnings last night. 14 billion hours streamed on there in the last quarter. But nonetheless, they're going to deal with some advertising problems through 2021. Roku down today. And we get Uber earnings after the bell today as well. Should be an interesting Thursday in the markets, folks. Stay tuned. Larry Pesavento is going to kick it off with the opening bell. He's coming up live next. We'll be right back.